All right, well, like, so we've just finished Matthew 12. This brings us, of course, to Matthew 13 and just about the halfway point now in Matthew.
That's right. That's right. And I'm just amazed again by the structure that Matthew gives to his gospel.
Right.
Because he, in Matthew chapter 12, we read about Jesus casting out demons, and then he was confronted by Pharisees and Sadducees. Mm-hmm. They were asking, scribes, they were asking, show us a sign. Mm-hmm. And on the other hand, there was another group of people who were watching Jesus, and they saw, like, wow, I guess this is truly the Messiah.
Right, right.
So, and at the end of this chapter, we see that there are disciples of Jesus who are called his brothers and sisters.
That's
and
great.
Mother. Yeah. So it gives us
disciples
hope.
Disciples of Jesus, you're his family.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. But in Matthew chapter 13, there is a paradox.
Okay.
And you will see now why.
A parable, a paradox.
Yeah. Exactly, parable and a paradox. In chapter 13, verses 1 and 2, we read that on the same day, Jesus went out of the house and sat by the sea. Mm-hmm. So everything that happened in chapter 12, and by the way, you can watch the entire episode on Matthew chapter 12. It's our previous episode. Don't forget to do that. And you too, if you were not there.
But right.
You were. And then, so he went out of the house, come down to the seaside, and great multitudes were gathered together to him, so that he got into a boat and sat, and the whole multitude stood on the shore.
Mm-hmm. It's kind of reminiscent of this Sermon on the Mount.
Exactly.
He's on the mountain, now he's down here.
Yes, absolutely. And what is happening here, imagine this crowd who knew that apparently he is the Messiah. They thought, oh yeah, I guess he is the Messiah.
They know he's the Messiah, but they don't really know what he's all about yet, necessarily, 100%.
Because they had only the messianic expectations of the past.
Right.
But they didn't think about Messiah being the Son of God.
Mm.
They thought about the warrior, Messiah, who would come and conquer Romans.
Mm-hmm.
And now when they're standing there, they're expecting him to give a very probably
give a general speech.
Yeah.
And
then
give a
they
rallying
will just,
cry.
Exactly. Then they will start fighting the Romans.
Huh. Okay.
But what Jesus does is outstanding. Mm-hmm. He says, "And I would like to tell you a story." And that story is about a sower who goes into the field and sows the seeds.
So he doesn't pull out a sword, he pulls out a
sower.
Yeah.
No, just no, not at all. And people are like, No, this cannot be true.
Mm.
Even his disciples, they approached him and said, "Teacher, why do you speak to them in parables?"
Right.
"They don't understand you. We don't understand you."
And I had always thought parables were a way to clarify, to give an easy story example of a way for people to remember and understand something. Mm-hmm. But really, it seems to perplex them, not give them clarity.
In fact, it seems like Jesus is coding his message.
Intentionally.
Hmm. And we will see what the mystery of the parable is.
And he only gives it to his disciples for some reason.
Yes.
And I guess we'll have to find out. Exactly. Tuesday at 9.
Join us.